So this is a recording of a group whiteboarding problem that we didn't get to for chapter 26. So you can see here we have a parallel plate capacitor, two round plates, and we're going to calculate the speed of an electron when it's put between the two plates. This is similar to the problem in your book, 26.8. The difference is in this problem we're given the charge on the plates, and in the one in the book we're given the number of electrons on the plates. So there's one more step in the book that you would need to do, so you can take a look at that. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to start out with a sheet of charge, or in this case, a disk of charge. And we know from what we've been doing in class and from your reading that the electric field for a sheet of charge is given as the electric field is given as the surface charge density eta over epsilon 0 times 2. So if we add in a second sheet of charge, and now notice that the one on the left is negative and the one on the right is positive, so that means that our electric field is going to point away from the positive towards the negative. And you can see that we'll have twice the electric field. We add up these lines, the red and the black lines, and so now this is for one sheet of charge, this equation here, but now when we have two sheets of charge, so for two sheets, I'm not sure why this is doing that, so two sheets, let's see. There we go. So for two sheets of charge, we have E is equal to 2 times eta over 2 epsilon 0. 2's cancel, and we're left with, for a parallel plate capacitor, we're left with E, the electric field is eta, the surface charge density, over epsilon 0. Okay, and so what about eta? So eta, let's see if I can get rid of that. Let's try that again. So two sheets, my E field is equal to 2 times eta over 2 epsilon 0. Cancel out my 2's, and I'm left with eta over epsilon 0. So now to calculate eta, so eta is surface charge density. And whenever you hear density, you're thinking it's got to be something over length, something over area, or something over volume. So our surface charge density here is over area. So eta is equal to the charge, Q, over the area. Or in this case, since we know they're both disks, it's going to be the charge, Q, over pi r squared. So now our E field, if we come from here, our E field for the parallel plate capacitor is going to be eta over epsilon 0 is equal to Q over epsilon 0. I'm substituting in for Q over pi r squared into the equation, and that's what I get. So that's my electric field here. Now that's great. I'm going to remember that. Maybe I'll copy it here. Copy. So I'm going to copy that, and I'm going to bring it to the next page. Let's bring that up here. So we remember that's our formula. And so now what we want to think about is the question asks us for the speed of an electron that's put in between these plates. So if I put an electron in between these plates, it's going to move because there's an electric field. And so what we want to know is how fast is it going to move. Well, as soon as we start talking about kinematics, we need to think about our kinematic equations, and we need to think about forces. So this electric field exerts a force on this electron. So we know that F is equal to ma, and we also know that F is equal to Q, the charge, times the electric field. And in our case, since it's an electron, it's going to be E, an electron, times the electric field. So now I want to solve for A, the acceleration, because the acceleration is what's going to lead me to get the velocity. So now A is equal to, I divide both sides of this equation and this equation by M, and I get A is equal to the charge on the electron times E over the mass of an electron. So I can rewrite that by plugging this equation in for E, and I have charge on an electron over the mass of an electron times Q over epsilon naught pi r squared, So great, now I can solve for A. So A is equal to, I'm going to plug in numbers, 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs is an electron. The mass of an electron is 9.11 times 10 times 10 to the negative 31 kilograms. The Q here, they tell us, is 16 times nanocoulombs, so that's times 10 to the negative 9 coulombs. My epsilon zero is 8.85 times 10 to the negative 12. And the units there are coulomb squared over newton meter squared. And then we have pi. And our radius is half of 0.06. So here they tell us in the problem that our electrodes are 6 centimeters in diameter. So my radius then is going to be 3 centimeters or 0.03 meters squared. And when I calculate this out and I use my calculator, I get that the acceleration is 1.12 times 10 to the 17th meters per second squared. And that makes sense here. I can look at my units. My coulombs on the top are squared. That cancels here. My meters here are squared, so that cancels here. I have a kilogram here, and I know my newtons are kilogram meter per second squared, so I know I'm going to have a kilogram cancel here, and then this comes up to the numerator, and I'm left with meters per second squared there. So that actually works. Now I can use my kinematic equation here, where I know the distance. So I'm letting this electron go right here, right at the positive plate, and it starts with no velocity, and I'm calling the edge right here zero. So I have I can use the equation, the simplified equation, d is equal to 1/2 a delta t squared. So I have no starting position, and I have no starting velocity. That's my assumption. Now in this equation, I know d, the separation between the plates, is 5 millimeters. I just calculated a, and so now I need to find delta t. So rearranging the equation, I can multiply both sides by 2 to get the to bring the 2 over, and I can divide by a. So I have 2, I multiply by 2, d over a is equal to delta t. And now if I take the square root of that, right, then that'll give me what my delta t is. So that's going to equal, I'm just going to write it over here, 2 times 0.005 meters. Over 1.12 times 10 to the 17th meters per second squared. Take the square root of that, and I find my time is really small, and it is 3 times 10 to the negative 10th. So that's the time it takes, seconds, to get from one plate to the other. And now I want to calculate velocity, and velocity is equal to a delta t. And that's going to equal, I plug in my numbers, 1.12 times 10 to the 17th meters per second squared times 3 times 10 to the negative 10th seconds. And so here I'm left with v is equal to 3.4 times 10 to the 7th meters per second. And so that's almost the speed of light. So my electron in that field moves almost at the speed of light, a factor of 10 or so less than that. And so that's it.